Hi guys, this is Chris from More Than Fly Legacy. I wanted to take a moment and do a brief tutorial on how to do a squirrel sculpin, a squirrel zonker sculpin pattern. It's a super simple pattern. I love this pattern. It's one of the two main patterns I go to when I'm using my Euro rod and I want to throw a streamer. I love this because it's really simple pattern, so you know when I lose one, it's not too painful, and it's really easy to tie, and it's really simple materials, and it's so darned effective. I love that it's able to actually pull out some of the bigger fish out of a run. And you can fish it dead drifted, you can strip it in, either way works really well. I love that the squirrel on it has a real inherent movement to it, so you don't actually have to impart a lot of motion to it for it to work. When I tie this, I use a super jig head. This is the super jig head by Wopsy. It's on a mustad hook, and I actually paint the heads. The three different sizes that I use, this is a 1/8 ounce jig, this here is a 1/16 ounce jig, and then a 1/32 ounce jig. I find in most cases I'll either use the 1/32 or 1/16 ounce. But there are some cases where I'm fishing really, really fast water and I just really need to cut through it, and I'll use the 1/8 ounce jig. It's pretty heavy and sometimes it's just really, really necessary, and it just gets to the fish that most people aren't getting to. When I paint these, I use a simple technique that I learned from a friend, and it works really well. I use nail polish for the sculpin pattern. I use this kind of olive color. It's a Sally Hansen's. It's a 838 evergreen, and then some white from Sally Hansen's. It's just 300 white on is what it's called, and then just a dab of some other red or pink color for the under part, for where the gills would be. So right now I'm going to show you how to tie this. Oh, also, I forgot to mention with that, with the nail polish, it would just chip off if you just use that by itself. So I'll actually use clear Gorilla Glue on top of that, and I'll just use nitrile gloves. I'll put a little bit of this onto some kind of disposable surface, like some cardboard or a napkin or something, and then I'll use nitrile gloves, and I'll just go through, and I'll do a whole bunch of these at once. I'll get a little bit on my fingers and then just coat it with my finger. Then I'll put these on a drying wheel and let them dry for a day. The reason that this is nice is because the Gorilla Glue has a little, it's not tacky, but it's a little softer surface, and so it gives it a little bit more resilience when it's hitting, like tapping against things, where the nail polish would just chip right off. This protects it. I've tried things like Softex before, and it works okay, but you have to coat it multiple times, and this gets pretty smelly. It's just easier to use the Gorilla Glue and just put it on a drying wheel. And so I do a whole bunch of those in one go. So I want to show you, though, how to tie this. It's really super simple. I love that it just gets down really deep. So I'll go ahead and let's do the 1/32 ounce jig right now. This is probably the one I use the most. I'm going to use, this is Ultra Thread in 70, and it's just olive color. So we'll start by just wrapping the shank on here, and I'll just wrap it back to the bend of the hook. Once I wrap it back there, I will grab a small section of squirrel. Now this is actually Sculpin olive. That's the color for this particular squirrel. What I'll do is I'll just clip a section for the tail, and I will invert that when I go to tie it in. And the reason I do that is because when this rides in the water, it's going to ride with the jig like this. And so it's just inverted for the tie-in. Next thing, all I do is I want to choose what color I want for the belly. And sometimes I'll use like a white ice dub. A lot of other times I will use a cream color. I actually really love cream color when I'm using, when I'm tying the belly of a lot of streamers. The reason I'll use the cream color is because it's just a really strong trigger point. But right now I'll just go ahead and use this white ice dub and just create a dubbing noodle. And I don't actually want to put on a whole lot, because the more material you put onto a streamer, the more likely the current will catch it and it won't let it sink as well. And so that's one of the cool things about this pattern, is it's just really sparse on materials but awesome on movement. Next, I'm going to take a longer segment of the same squirrel. I'm going to measure it to where the end of the leather is going to end right at the bend of the hook. Now, if you wanted to put this on and tie it a little longer and then clip it, that's okay too. If you don't want to be too specific, I'm going to get that wet and split the fibers there. I'm going to tie it on, and I kind of aim it at me a little bit when I tie it on. That way, when I tie it on, it actually lands up on the top. Once I kind of lock that in, I'm going to wrap in front of it a couple times, and then I will actually take the squirrel, and I will wrap it around twice. Once I've wrapped that around, I will lock it in. Super simple here. Wrap in front of it a couple. Clip off the extra right there. And I'm going to pull that back and make a couple wraps here just to kind of wrap over the fibers a little bit. And the reason I'm doing that is they don't get in the way. See how it kind of pushed them back? They won't get in the way as much when I go to tie in the pectoral fins. So I've just cut two little tiny segments of this, and I'm going to tie them in on each side for pectoral fins. That's the kind of defining feature. That's what makes this a little different than just a regular squirrel leech pattern, is these pectoral fins and the lighter belly. It's meant to look more like a bait fish rather than like a sculpin rather than just a leech. This is actually a pattern that I've modified a little bit, not too much, but a little bit. I saw it done by on Instagram by Justin Aldrich, I think is his name. And I'm going to trim those pectoral fins because they're a little bit long. Anyway, he used like a tungsten bead and that kind of stuff. And this I actually like because it's cheaper. It gets down just as well. And I've got a little bit bigger hook. So I trimmed all those now so they kind of line up a little bit better. All I'm going to do now that I've got those pectoral fins tied in, you can kind of see how they flay out. And when it's going through the water, they'll kind of flay out a little bit. The reason I didn't tie this in, the one that I ran to the front from that back part, the reason I used to actually tie that in as one long piece from the tail all the way up to the front. The reason I don't do that, is because it's a bugger to tie this in like this underneath the hook and then to get it to come around on the top and then go over it. Now, you can do that, but I just don't think it's quite as necessary. If you also did this extra section like I did that's loose, when it's going through the water, it generally stays on the top, but it can kind of flare up a little bit. And I actually think that kind of plays a little bit of peekaboo with the fish and can kind of taunt them a little bit more. They can get a flash of that white that's in there. And it's a little bit more of a trigger, in my opinion. So now I'm just going to take a little bit of super glue on the thread, pull my fibers up out of the way, and then just wrap around there, and then just do a whip finish a couple times. And it's done. Really, really simple pattern. It does. It's amazing how well this works. I can't even tell you. Once you can kind of get the trick of how to fish it on a Euro rod, keeping it suspended in most cases, a little bit above the bottom of the river, it's crazy how well it works. So tie some up. Give it a try. This is a go-to for those of you who want to use streamers on your Euro rod. Good luck.